E daí? Ok, good.
Good evening. I am very happy to be here. I would like to thank you all for this invitation. In particular, Mario Biagini, Aganieszka, Pauline, and Jorge, and the team of Towards Constellations for making this meeting possible. I would like to introduce my friend, Christopher Mack. He will help with translation, especially in moments of the guided meditation. But we can help me in other moments too. My name is Cassiano Quilic. I am a professor and researcher in a public university in the state of São Paulo in Brazil. I have been working with the relationships between creative process in performing arts and ways of training perception and attention based on contemplative practices of exercises. I also have been exploring certain connections between perception exercises and writing. I am very interested in amplifying the meaning of artistic action, including stage theater and other forms of intervention in public life. Actions and performances, cultural events, educational process, and I believe that now these experiences have been acquiring new meanings and functions because we are living through a radical crisis of ways of life on the planet. And this crisis is different according to where we live. For example, in Brazil, we have such a serious situation. I will talk about it, but there is a global crisis too. And I think that the dialogue between performative art and certain traditional practices can have an important place in this moment, because we need to develop a fine perception and understanding of this moment if we want to discover more efficient forms of action. Well, I would like to establish an informal conversation among us, and I intend to divide our time in three parts. First, I will say something about my personal experience with meditation in the Buddhist context. After, I will propose a guided practice for 20 minutes more or less, so that we talk based on an experience. Then you will be free to ask me any questions you might have. Finally, I will share ideas for combining meditation and creative process, especially in performing arts. Okay. My first contact with meditation was in the context of Zen Buddhism. São Paulo, the city where I live, it has a great number of Japanese immigrants, and there are a number of Buddhist temples and some following the Zen lineage. I began to practice in Bushinji Temple, linked to the Soto Zen tradition. The relationships between Zen and art are well known and easy to recognize. There are many forms of Zen art: no theater, martial arts, calligraphy, tea ceremony, poetry, among others. Zen established a clear idea of art as a spiritual way. Art is a vehicle, as Grotowski said. And these forms survive until today. Here in São Paulo, for example, there is an amateur association of no theater. Some performers of this group practice Zen meditation, Zazen. The connection between Zen and no is clearly visible. The slow movement, the containment of action, the high degree of concentration. Even in dramaturgy, we find elements of Buddhist cosmology, divinities, ghosts, demons. The common theme of no place is the stories of beings trapped in the samsara cycle, aspiring to liberation. In general, this is the form that no narrates the suffering of living beings. But for us, Western practitioners, no theater is an extremely codified art. It's beautiful, but difficult to learn. Even so, there are some young Brazilians, artists, developing powerful work in this form of art. But my path was different. I had the opportunity to meet monks of Theravada lineage, the oldest school of Buddhism. Theravada is present in Sri Lanka, Thailand, Myanmar, and more recently in some Western countries, as well as here in Brazil. My friends of Casa de Dharma and I began to make contact with some monks and organize retreats. And we studied and practiced with great professors such as Bhante Gunaratna, Bhante Rahula, Bhante Buddharakita, and later with several other monks and masters, also from the forest tradition of Thailand, people to whom I am deeply grateful. Since then, I've been continuing to try to learn and practice with some seriousness. And in a way, it was inevitable that I would establish bridges with performing arts. As Achan Jayasaro has defined it, meditation is only one part of a vast system of the education of the body-mind called Dhamma or Dharma. We are used to thinking of religion as a belief system. We need a certain degree of faith or trust to start the practice. But Dhamma is a collection of teachings, is a kind of map designed to cultivate qualities of heart and mind, giving rise to a process of awakening or emancipation. This point is very important because we note that in the Western countries, meditation has become a vague word that can designate different kinds of exercises. Frequently, it's associated with a technique to deal with stress, to promote relax and tranquility. I think this is one possible function of this practice. If we consider the pressure that people are submitted to the neoliberal environment. But it's important to comment something about this capacity of contemporary culture to observe traditional techniques, sometimes restricting or even distorting their original meaning. For example, there are some versions of mindfulness meditation used by improve the competition performance in the global capitalism, or presented as a panacea to many kinds of diseases and mental problems caused by a stressful way of life. My idea here is that in the field of art, particularly performing arts, the dialogue and the meeting with these traditions can be much richer and profound, both in terms of investigating the dimension of perception in the work of the performer and as a way of rethinking the place of art in present times. To develop this idea, I would like to explain some details about the exercise and propose a small experience after. In terms of a specific practice, Buddhist meditation can start with development of a certain level of serenity. Firstly, you need to relax the body in a good posture and to observe the mind's tendency to grasp many subjects and ideas. The mind is hungry and afraid of emptiness. We can learn to see this and lead it back to the breath. When we repeat this procedure in a gentle way, there can be a greater degree of relaxation and equanimity. It's possible to discover interesting things about the relationships between body and mind, how the state of mind influences the body and vice versa. We can experience a living immobility. I think of some of Beckett's characters or Maeterlinck plays in which there is very little movement and how we work with a certain quality of energy and presence in these cases. The work with the energy of breathing is so important in the meditation process. A certain representation about what breathing is dismantled. Breathing isn't only the mechanical process of taking in and expelling air. It involves the arousal and disappearance of many subtle sensations in the body, an energetic process that Eastern medicine calls circulation of qi, or chi, or prana. Perceiving these feelings more clearly, the mind naturally tends to become still. It's a long work, but when you get certain stability, the perception becomes more subtle because the energy is not so dispersed. So you can use this quality of to investigate the body-mind in microscopic perspective. You learn to discern more clearly the qualities of states of body-mind. If this is a gross state, based on the tendency to react with aversion or greed to objects and circumstances. Or when we are captured in the fantasies of ego, the desires of being someone, and so on. Sometimes you can have a surprise and notice something different arising, something more fresh, more subtle, more free. And the question becomes, how can I develop these states? How can I discover something that I didn't know? It's a twofold process. We need to let go of the gross status and to open space for higher qualities of consciousness. Okay, now it's important that we have a practical experience. And now I start to speak in Portuguese, and my friend Christopher helps me in the translation. Vamos lá. Nós poderemos praticar sentados no chão ou na cadeira.
So, we can practice sitting down on the floor or sitting in a chair.
Se estivermos sentados no chão, poderemos cruzar as pernas. Vou mostrar aqui, né?
Pode ser. So, if you're sitting on the floor, you can cross your legs like this.
Like this or like this. Na cadeira é importante que não encostemos no apoio.
So, if you're sitting in a chair, it's important that you don't lean back against the chair.
Sustentar a coluna é uma maneira de manter o tônus da postura.
So, sustaining your column is a way of maintaining the tone of the posture.
Talvez você tenha que falar um pouco mais alto, eu acho que tá.
Yeah.
As mãos podem estar em cima dos joelhos ou perto do abdômen.
So you can place your hands on your legs or close to your abdomen.
O queixo paralelo ao chão.
Your chin parallel to the floor.
E os olhos podem estar fechados ou semiabertos, olhando na direção do chão.
And so your eyes can be closed or directed towards the floor.
Importante que seja uma postura relativamente confortável.
It's important that your posture is relatively comfortable.
E nós vamos ficar 20 minutos. Mas se você sentir muito desconforto na posição sentado, você pode ficar de pé.
So we're going to spend around 20 minutes, and if for some reason you feel uncomfortable, you should feel free to stand.
Sendo que essa transição da posição sentada para a posição de pé deve ser feita bem conscientemente.
So the transition from being seated to standing should be one of considerable awareness and consciousness.
Ok, eu vou marcar o tempo com o sino.
I will mark the time with the bell.
Ok. Trazendo a atenção para a sensação do corpo.
Bringing the attention to the feeling of the body.
O contato do corpo com o chão.
The contact of the body with the floor.
A sensação do peso.
The feeling of weight.
Percepção do contorno do corpo.
The perception of the outline of the body.
Percebendo as tensões mais grosseiras no corpo.
Perceiving more gross extensions in the body.
E relaxando na expiração.
And relaxing in breathing.
Na inspiração, traz energia para o corpo.
Inhaling and bringing energy into the body.
Relaxando bem o rosto.
Relaxing the face.
Os ombros.
The shoulders,
as mãos, os pés,
the hands, the feet,
sustentando a coluna vertebral,
sustaining the spine,
mantendo a energia da postura,
holding on to the energy of the posture.
É um estado de relaxamento, mas a mente está desperta.
It's a state of relaxation of the body, but the mind is alert.
O corpo como uma montanha.
The body as a mountain.
Transmitindo uma sensação de estabilidade e serenidade.
Transmitting a sensation of stability and serenity.
Uma imobilidade viva.
Living immobility.
Trazendo a atenção agora para a respiração.
Bringing the attention to the breathing.
Podendo fazer 3 respirações mais profundas.
Now taking three deeper breaths.
Tornando nítido a sensação da respiração.
Making the feeling of breathing more clear.
Percebendo a energia que a respiração traz para o corpo.
Perceiving the energy that breathing brings to the body.
Pode-se explorar a sensação da respiração em diferentes partes do corpo.
You can explore the experience of breathing in different parts of the body.
Observa-se a tendência da mente procurar objetos, assuntos.
Observing the tendency of the mind to seek objects and subjects.
Reconhecemos quando isso acontece. E de uma maneira gentil, trazemos de novo a atenção para a respiração.
We recognize this. And when we do, we bring the breathing back to the body.
Pode-se observar a respiração agora apenas no abdômen.
We can observe the breathing now just in the abdomen.
Deixando que ela aconteça espontaneamente, sem tentar corrigir.
Allowing it to flow spontaneously without trying to correct it.
quando a mente se distrai, relaxamos o corpo, deixamos a atenção repousar na respiração.
When the mind is distracted, we allow the breath to take us back to the body.
Se há sonolência, podemos respirar mais profundamente algumas vezes e depois retornar à respiração natural.
If we feel tiredness, we can take deeper breaths and allow the breathing to return to its natural rhythm.
Se há incômodos no corpo, na postura, dores, podemos observar essas sensações, como elas surgem, se transformam, depois retornamos para a respiração.
If we feel pain or discomfort in the body, we can reflect on this and once again allow the breathing to return us to the body.
Observamos como cada respiração é diferente da outra.
We observe how each breath is different from the last.
A respiração não só como a entrada e a saída do ar, mas as sensações que surgem quando inspira, quando se expira.
Breathing not only as taking in and letting go of air, but of the feeling of inhaling and exhaling.
Aos poucos, abrimos a atenção para os sons do lugar em que você está.
Gradually bringing attention to sounds and the place where you are.
Percebendo sons aparecendo e desaparecendo como vibrações.
Perceiving sounds as coming and going, as vibrations.
A sensação do espaço em torno,
the feeling of the surrounding space,
aos poucos vamos abrindo os olhos, sentindo o toque da luz.
Gradually opening our eyes and feeling the touch of the light.
E quando quiser, podemos nos espreguiçar.
And when you wish, we can stretch.
Temos um tempo agora, se alguém quiser fazer alguma pergunta ou algum compartilhamento da experiência, depois eu vou prosseguir falando das relações entre esse tipo de prática e o trabalho do performer.
So, if anyone would like to ask any questions or has anything they would like to say at this point, feel free. And now Cassiano will talk about some of the potential connections between this type of experience and the performer.
Você pode usar o chat, se quiser, né? Fazer questões.
If anyone wants to pose a question in the chat, feel free.
Vamos continuar. Okay, we can continue. Opa. Some questions.
How do you use this practice with your students?
Luciano, você pode falar ainda um pouco mais sobre esse trabalho, sobre o texto, depois como... Tá, tem várias questões aqui. Primeiro, Tatiana vai ter que falar.
So, the first question from Tatiana, Tatiana's asking if Cassiano could say a little more about his work on the text.
Sim, esse trabalho eu comecei a desenvolver já há um certo tempo e eu tento estabelecer uma relação entre o ato de escrever e um certo estado inicial que você trabalha a partir do exercício da meditação. Então, um certo silenciamento.
So, the process really is begins with an initial state of perhaps silencing the body, of relaxation, that is a preliminary to the experience of writing.
De algum modo, a meditação nos coloca em contato com sensações, ou emoções, ou mesmo ideias que ainda não estão tão definidas, né, tão nomeadas.
So, in a sense, meditation puts us into contact with certain feelings, emotions, and ideas that are not fully formed.
Então, acho interessante essa passagem, né, entre uma experiência do silêncio e a experiência do tentar trazer para a palavra o que você experimentou.
So, I think it's interesting to experience this passage and to bring some of that transition, that liminar experience into words.
Existem outras pessoas pesquisando esse assunto que eu acho interessante nós citarmos aqui.
So there are a number of other people researching this subject, and I think it's important that we make reference.
Eu fiz a co-orientação de um trabalho, uma pesquisa de doutorado da Diana de Holanda.
So I was co-supervisor of doctoral research of, what's her name?
Diana de Holanda.
Diana de Holanda.
Que desenvolveu um trabalho muito interessante, né, das relações entre a meditação no contexto do budismo Theravada e a escrita.
So she has developed some very interesting work about the relationship between Theravada Buddhism and the experience of writing.
Mas esse é um assunto bastante vasto, sim, né? Que depois nós poderemos conversar mais aí, Tatiana.
It's a very big subject, and Tatiana, perhaps we can talk about this in more detail in the future.
Okay.
Other questions.
Okay. How do you this practice with your students?
I can say this in English.
Okay. Tem sido uma experiência bastante interessante, inclusive nos tempos agora da pandemia, do ensino à distância, o uso da meditação.
Well, the use of meditation has become, in some sense, perhaps even more relevant in terms of experiences at a distance.
Às vezes, no começo da aula, dos encontros, eu proponho uma prática de uns 10 minutos de silêncio, nem chamo de meditação.
So, you know, I quite often begin meetings and classes with 10 minutes of silence, and I don't even specifically call it meditation.
E eu tenho sentido que isso é uma forma de criar uma conexão inicial no grupo, uma forma de ritualização do começo do trabalho na aula.
Yeah, so, in a sense, it's a kind of ritualization, let's say, that initiates a meeting, a class.
É, nos tempos da nosso convívio presencial, eu propus na Unicamp um grupo aberto para funcionários e professores e estudantes para uma prática na hora do almoço, que foi muito interessante também.
So, when we were still able to meet face to face, I was proposing open meetings during lunch at the University of Campinas for students, teachers, and employees of the university, something completely open.
Era uma prática fora de contexto de curso, uma prática não, que não é paga, que qualquer um pode fazer. E eu acho isso muito interessante, criar esse tipo de espaço.
So, it was a meeting outside of the context of any course, completely free, open, unpaid, and I think it's really interesting to create this type of experience, this type of space.
Mas eu acho que tem muitos tipos de aplicação, inclusive nas aulas específicas de teatro, que depois eu vou desenvolver mais na minha fala aqui.
So, you know, I think that there are some very specific applications in particular in relation to theater, which I will be developing in the rest of my presentation here.
Tem outra questão.
Acho que tem várias outras perguntas aqui. Eu acho que a gente vai ter que descer aqui. Espera aí.
Várias. Vamos do lado comecinho.
It's interesting for me to observe and feel some pains in my body, like barriers to go.
Espera aí. To go. Aonde?
Aqui.
To go deeper. It's very interesting, this observation. Mm-hmm. Because there is relationships between the pain, the sensation, and the thoughts that we create from the sensation. And it's very important that we observe the difference between sensation and the thoughts.
Mario makes a point here. He says that he's very interested in this transitional fields, whether between silence and word or between people, transitional spaces.
Yeah.
And he makes a reference to Winnicott.
Ah, yes. Now, eu tenho a respeito da outra pergunta. Eu tenho um exemplo muito interessante. Uma vez eu fui levar meus dois filhos pequenos para tomar uma vacina.
So, just referring to the previous point,
Cassian was sharing an experience that he took his two young sons to be vaccinated.
É, o meu filho um pouco mais velho, quando viu as crianças chorando, começou a ficar muito ansioso.
And so when my elder son when he heard other children crying, he became very anxious.
Começou a prever o que ia acontecer e que ia ser uma dor horrível.
He started to foresee what was going to happen and that it would be some terrible pain.
O meu filho mais novo estava um pouco dormindo e não reparou muito na situação.
And my younger son was a little sleepy and didn't really kind of pay attention to the situation.
Ele não criou pensamentos sobre o que iria acontecer quando ele tomasse a picada.
So he didn't create any expectations or ideas about what was going to happen when he took the injection.
Então a dor que ele sentiu da picada foi menor do que todo o sofrimento e o drama que meu filho mais velho experimentou.
So the pain in a sense for my younger son was less than, you know, the dramatization and the expectation that my older son experienced.
É, e nós somos um pouco assim, né? Nós criamos muitos dramas e muitos pensamentos em torno das nossas sensações.
And we are a little like that in the sense that we create dramas and ideas about feelings.
E a meditação ensina você a separar o que é uma sensação e o que é um pensamento.
And meditation in a sense helps to separate what is a feeling and from a thought.
E que dores, num certo sentido, nós sempre vamos ter, porque faz parte da vida.
And pain is something that we will always feel because it's part of life.
Mas há um sofrimento que nós criamos em cima disso, que é um sofrimento também mental. E isso nós podemos trabalhar.
But there's an additional suffering that we create in thinking about this pain. And this is something that we can work on with meditation.
Okay. Obrigado pela pergunta.
Thank you for that comment. And
qual que é a próxima?
So Mario made the comment about Winnicott and these transitional spaces here.
The meditation has to do.
Ele está interessado nesse campo.
Onde está?
Aqui.
I am very interested in the transitional field, whatever between silence and words, or between people, transitional spaces from this point of view, Winnicott.
It's very interesting.
Onde está?
From this point of view,
Winnicott is very interesting on the side of psychoanalysis. Sem dúvida. É interessante porque a nossa atenção às vezes não percebe essas transições, né?
It's fascinating because sometimes our attention doesn't recognize these transitions.
Por exemplo, essa experiência de um sentimento, de uma sensação que ainda não está formulado como em palavras, em linguagem.
For example, a sentiment or a feeling that hasn't arrived or is beyond words.
E muitas vezes por exemplo, no caso de uma criança pequena, é a mãe que fala pela criança, né? Fala assim, você está se sentindo assim, como você está? Tem uma reverie, né? Tem uma...
There's this dynamic between mothers and young children, infants, that the mother names in through a process of reverie, the feelings that the child has.
E isso é uma coisa importante porque a criança também se sente mais tranquila com essa tradução que a mãe faz dos seus supostos aí, sentimentos.
Yeah, so, and this is obviously incredibly important because in many ways the child feels more secure in the translation of these feelings and emotions.
Por causa da relação que a criança pode ter com a mãe, né, de proteção, de confiança.
Because of this relationship with the mother of trust and security, in a sense, a type of containment.
Mas a meditação, eu acho que pode nos ensinar, né, as pessoas adultas também, a ficar mais tempo com experiências e sensações e sentimentos que a gente ainda não nomeou.
And I think similarly, I think meditation for children or adults alike can help us with these as yet unnamed experiences and feelings and guide us through that transition.
Porque às vezes nós já colocamos um rótulo no que nós experimentamos, e isso de alguma maneira fixa a nossa experiência, nossa compreensão também.
Yeah, sometimes we're very quick to label and to name sensations and feelings that we have, and meditation is a form perhaps of giving ourselves time and space before applying these labels and names.
E talvez a linguagem poética seja aquela que consegue transitar melhor entre aquilo que já está mais codificado e reconhecido e uma experiência que ainda nós não temos muita clareza.
So, perhaps, you know, poetic language offers us that possibility of a place between codified concrete language and a place that and a feeling, in fact, that has not been or cannot be named.
Agora, é claro que para você ser um poeta, você também tem que ter o conhecimento específico da linguagem, o artesanato com a linguagem. Não basta só você ter esse tipo de experiência.
Well, obviously, to be a poet, it's not enough alone to just have this type of experience. You need to develop your relationship with language as a craft.
Mas talvez esse tipo de exercício seja um pouco que eu falaria a respeito do ator. Existem habilidades específicas, né, que o performer tem que desenvolver. Mas esse tipo de exercício é também uma espécie de, entre aspas, treinamento do campo perceptivo.
So this is a type of, in a sense, can be understood as a kind of training for the performative field. And I'm going to be saying some more about that with respect to the performer as I continue my presentation.
Ok, thank you. Tem mais
um? Não sei quanto tempo a gente tem para responder todas essas perguntas.
Acho que as perguntas são interessantes, né? Porque
tem uma discussão. There's we're just reading. Obviously, people have asked a number of questions and made a number of comments here. Mario mentions Epstein in relation to Buddhist practice.
Wrote in an interesting yes, Epstein wrote in an interesting way about meditational practices and therapy
on another note.
Another note, do you observe that a clear or lucid or transparent fluid deconstructed attention or pause meditational practices appear visibly in organic fluid behavior? Eu não entendi muito o que você pode traduzir.
Ele está dizendo que ele está perguntando se você observa uma atenção desconstruída em atividades práticas pós-meditar que aparecem de uma forma orgânica no comportamento. Ele fala num certo sentido em comportamento mais preciso, assim,
tá,
relax the tension.
Acho que é muito importante esse contexto mais amplo do budismo para falar da meditação.
Sorry, can you repeat?
Acho que é muito importante esse contexto mais amplo do budismo para falar da meditação.
Well, I think it's important, like a broader perspective on Buddhism in terms of meditation.
Porque a meditação sentada é só uma prática.
Because seated meditation is just one form of practice.
Você, num certo sentido, tem que levar essa qualidade de atenção para outras posturas e situações da sua vida diária.
So, in a sense, you have to take this type of practice into other everyday experiences beyond what we would conventionally understand as a seated meditation practice. And I think Cassiano is going to say something about the extended field.
Eu acho que nós podemos continuar na conversa. Eu acho mais interessante do que fazer uma exposição formal.
Cassiano saying it, you know, perhaps it would be more interesting to continue this type of conversation than to go into the formality of the rest of his presentation. And does anyone have an opinion about the idea of continuing this as an open conversation?
Yes. Mas continuando, na meditação sentada, essa atenção ela é mais intensa.
In the seated meditation, this type of attention is more intense.
Porque você tem poucos estímulos, pouco movimento, então você pode entrar numa dimensão microscópica da experiência.
Eu estava lendo.
We have few stimuli and few movements, and we need to enter in the microscopic dimension of the experience in the sitting meditation.
Essa pessoa vindo do Marasani pergunta, é possível meditar com os olhos fechados?
Com os olhos fechados?
Yes. Abertos.
Sim. A ideia da meditação, inclusive por exemplo, se você está praticando sentado, se você estiver com muito sono, é mais interessante que você deixe o olho aberto.
To respond to the question from Bindu Marasani about is it possible to meditate, Cassiano was saying that, you know, for example, if you're practicing meditation in the seated position and you are feeling particularly tired, then meditation with your eyes open is a way of working through that experience.
Mas retornando à pergunta anterior, é muito importante que você traga essa qualidade de atenção para suas atividades diárias.
But just returning to the previous point from Mario, Castellano thinks it's fundamentally important to bring this form of attention into everyday life in various contexts.
E há práticas específicas para isso, por exemplo, a meditação andando, ou mesmo você, em alguns momentos, fazer as suas atividades de uma maneira mais lenta, mais atenta. É um tipo de treino.
So, you know, there are particular forms of practices in relation to this, such as walking, meditation, and... And in fact, in any activity, it becomes a question of attention and the type of perhaps slowing down the action can bring a different quality to the experience.
Okay. Vamos ver mais algumas perguntas. Epstein, tem Cassiano.
Isso já passou.
Já passou. Isso já. Aqui. Hello, everyone. I have a small question. Almost people meditate with...
Isso já foi.
Thank you. For me, this is a point of contact between performance practice and meditational practices, in the sense that something changes in the behavior of the person. I don't talk, of course, of forms of performing, but of
performers.
Forms of performing? Ah, tá. But of
performers.
Mas aqui embaixo. But of performers.
Não, performers.
Ah, performers. É um erro de ortografia.
Ah, tá. Qual que é?
Isso.
Pode traduzir?
Ele está dizendo que é um ponto de contato entre práticas performativas e práticas de meditação, no sentido que alguma coisa muda no comportamento da pessoa. Ele não está falando de formas de performar, mas da pessoa.
Sim, sim. Acho que não é o caso de transformar a meditação numa espécie de técnica.
So, it's not a question of turning meditation into a type of technique.
Para usar diretamente no palco.
To use directly on the stage, for example.
Esse tipo de uso geralmente cria clichês.
This type of use quite commonly results in clichés.
I am very spiritual actor or a kind of solemnity in the posture. This is not the case. But I think that meditation is a form to amplify the idea of Stanislavski idea, for example, of the work of the actor on himself.
And on themselves.
On themselves. This famous idea. It's another kind of training.
There's an interesting question, Cassiano, here from Lena Lapris, who says, I'll translate briefly, que meditação tem a ver com equanimidade, a observação de feelings, de sentidos, e não reagindo, mas se atuar, assim, acting, tem a ver com a experiência dessas emoções e reações. Are they compatible?
Eu vou responder em português, porque acho que é melhor fazer a pergunta em inglês primeiro, né, para as pessoas ouvirem.
Yeah, so Elena asked this question about meditation, and saying that meditation is related to being
equanimous and observing sensations and not reacting, but acting has to do with the experience of these emotions and reactions. How are these things compatible?
Eu faria uma diferença entre reagir e responder a uma situação.
So, I think Cassiano is making a distinction between reacting to a situation and responding to a situation.
Reagir é a forma mais automática e mais padronizada que nós temos de lidar com uma situação.
So, reacting is, in a sense, a type of automatic way of experiencing situations.
E tem a ver com os nossos padrões, nossos condicionamentos, nossos estados mais grosseiros.
So, it's related to, it's much more strongly related to our conditioning. And more gross states of feeling and thought.
E a meditação cria espaço para você não reagir como você já está acostumado.
And meditation opens up a space in which it's possible not to react in the way that we are accustomed to reacting.
Você pode perceber melhor a situação e respondê-la de uma maneira mais interessante.
So,
mais lúcida.
You can, in a sense, it opens you up to responding in a more lucid way.
Open space.
It opens the space to a more lucid response.
E isso não tem a ver com você necessariamente fazer as coisas de uma maneira lenta.
And this doesn't necessarily mean that, or imply that you are in some way doing things more slowly, responding more slowly.
Esse é outro estereótipo que se cria a respeito de meditação, ou as pessoas que praticam meditação são pessoas muito... muito lento, quase vegetais.
So, really, this is a kind of stereotype, and this idea of speed, you know, of slowing things down and a slower rhythm, a slower pace, is really quite a stereotype associated, obviously, strongly with meditation.
Vegetable meditators. mas você... pode, a lentidão é apenas recurso, um instrumento, mas você pode treinar esse tipo de atenção em atividades mais rápidas e situações que você tem que ter uma resposta rápida.
So, you know, slowing things down is just one approach. And in fact, in this form of attention, it's possible to train and to develop this type of awareness in a situation that requires you to respond very quickly and in a different, absolutely different type of rhythm.
Por isso que algumas pessoas que treinam artes marciais meditam.
This is why people that practice, many people that practice martial arts also meditate.
Se fosse uma coisa ruim, se deixassem eles muito lentos, eles não meditariam.
Yes, if it was something bad and and didn't help in that way, then they simply just wouldn't meditate. Acho que tem bastante coisa ainda para frente.
A gente vai até.
Let me. I'm sorry.
Temos 10 minutos.
Aga is asking quais são os obstáculos mais comuns, assim, no sentido de obstáculos assim para a meditação, para a prática, que você encontra entre os seus alunos. So, to respond to Aga's question about the most common obstacles to meditation that
Cassiano encounters among his students.
Existem obstáculos bem comuns. Um deles é a sonolência.
There are some, you know, particularly common obstacles. One of which is tiredness.
É difícil da pessoa compreender que ela pode estar parada e ao mesmo tempo atenta e com energia.
So sometimes it's difficult for people to, for students to comprehend that you can, on one hand, be still, but at the same time be attentive. And sometimes that's quite considerably difficult for people to understand.
Por isso, às vezes, é importante fazer uma prática preliminar com movimento, com que a pessoa possa experimentar uma energia mais expansiva.
So, sometimes this is when it becomes important to develop some type of physical dimension that você diria que stimulates.
Uma prática mais expansiva no começo.
A more expansive practice in the beginning can be very important for this.
And after you can propose sitting meditation, but the posture is so important because, for example, this kind of posture is not so good. Because after some time, você vai cair no sono.
You will, you know, if the posture is not right, inevitably you will become tired.
Yes, and o que é uma postura sustentada, mas não rígida, não uma postura militar.
Yes, it has to be, you know, a sustained posture, but not a rigid one, you know, not something militaristic.
Yes. Esse é um problema. Outro problema é lidar com a dor, com o incômodo.
Another problem that's commonly faced is dealing with pain in the body.
E aí a pessoa tem que saber relaxar, né? E aprendendo a relaxar da postura, relaxar os músculos, ter outras práticas de relaxamento, né?
And so, really the person has to learn to develop a way of really relaxing the body, and
alongamento,
stretching, for example.
Mas também a gente tem que compreender que sempre um pouco de incômodo e um pouco de dor faz parte.
You know, it's important to recognize that a little discomfort and pain is part of the process.
A meditação também é uma forma da gente entrar em contato com com os limites do corpo.
So meditation is also a form of making contact with the limits of the body.
É preciso desenvolver um pouco da paciência também para lidar com esses desconfortos, coisa que na nossa cultura não é muito incentivado.
It's important to develop a degree of patience in terms of these this type of discomfort, and that's not something that is really incentivized in contemporary society in general.
Quando uma pessoa sente às vezes um pouco de dor, ela já quer que aquilo desapareça rapidamente.
And you know, so when a person feels a little pain, they immediately want that pain to disappear somehow.
Isso é um problema cultural, né?
This is a cultural problem.
Agora, acho que também tem pessoas que têm dificuldades em meditar e que talvez não seja também o caso, porque ficam muito
às vezes ansiosas ou com medo. Então, acho que a gente tem que saber desse tipo de limite para essa prática, né?
You know, there are certain limits to this practice for certain people who, you know, will inevitably hold on to anxieties and struggle in the process.
Mas, de forma geral, eu acho que tem que ir criando uma certa compreensão do que você está fazendo e não ser só uma nova técnica, né? Um truque, uma coisa assim.
Yeah, so, I mean, I think Cassiano was saying that it's important to develop this kind of general comprehension and not to think about this as a device or a technique, in a sense. Eu acho que a gente respondeu bastante essa pergunta, mas vamos ver o que...
Vamos ver mais, acho que dá para mais uma.
Meaning the change in spontaneous behavior can be compared to certain moments in acting or singing or dancing. Okay, there's a question asked at the beginning from meditation has to do... I think we responded to this... question here about the compatibility of meditation and acting. Vamos ver um pouco mais. There's one question in the Q&R window from João Ribeiro.
What about breathing?
Que tal fala sobre respiração? Foi difícil só deixar fluir. Eu comecei a controlar a respiração. É permissível fazer som enquanto respiramos? That's a very funny comment from Thelma Carrizosa, who says, you know, is it acceptable to make a sound while we breathe? You know, it's this kind of difficulty with controlling or not controlling, in fact, letting go.
É engraçado porque às vezes quando você fala para deixa a respiração acontecer espontaneamente, aí que a pessoa começa, ai meu Deus.
Cassiano is saying it's funny because, you know, sometimes the moment that you say, you know, let the breathing flow spontaneously, that's precisely the moment that it occurs to someone to start thinking about controlling it.
Se a respiração tiver te dando muita preocupação, você desloca a tua atenção para o corpo.
So, if you're becoming overly attentive to the breathing process, then that would be the time to focus again on the body.
Você pode relaxar mais profundamente o corpo, perceber o corpo, ele é mais, o que eu estou chamando aqui, né, de corpo, é assim, é mais concreto, mais denso, então é mais fácil da gente trazer atenção para ele, né?
You know, in a sense, the body is more solid, in some ways it's more concrete, and in a sense, it's easier for us to bring our attention back to the body in a sense sometimes when that difficulty with breathing becomes
a gente chama a respiração do elemento ar do corpo.
We call this the breathing of the air element in the body.
Existe o elemento terra, que é esse lado mais concreto do corpo, né? A sensação do peso.
So there's the earth element, this feeling of the body, the sense of the weight of the body as the earth element.
E há muita coisa para trabalhar nesse campo, né? Em termos de percepção das tensões.
And so there's a great deal of work to be done in that particular field in terms of sensations and...
Mas o fato de você ter percebido que os seus pensamentos ficaram muito agitados com relação à respiração é interessante, né? Você percebeu que isso aconteceu, né?
So it's interesting that you, Thelma, noticed that, you know, she was having this awareness of thinking about the breathing and the consciousness of it being something that was troubling you, and that in itself is interesting and something that can be developed.
Eu acho que eu vou terminar lendo só um trechinho da minha, do resto da minha, da minha fala, para não ficar muito frustrado.
So Cassiano was just saying that he would like to read just a part of the continuation of his presentation before we finish.
Because I think that this part is interesting to clarify the relationships between this kind of practice and performing arts. Theravada Buddhism haven't a close relationships with art like Zen. But if you observe a good monk or a good master, you notice a certain quality of presence, a kind of nobility, a peaceful atmosphere in the small gestures. Or I understood that they practice a kind of art of existence, or better, an art of crossing the existence. They are training all the time this human capacity to experience the life without attachment and aversion, without solidifying an image of the self, an ego, dissolving the illusion of substantiality. This is a very radical image of art in the expanded field. We can evoke an expression of Joseph Beuys, the performer. The expression is the anthropological meaning of art. Art is a human way to do and to be. And perhaps we are losing this in our modern way of life. Perhaps we are running the risk of losing our human condition. I'm not saying that people shouldn't practice art in the strict sense, developing specific languages like theater, dance, music, poetry. But the art of existence can be considered as a background for to cultivating good art. Acho que essa é uma maneira boa de terminar.
Well,
it's a good form to finish. But I prepared other things in my exposition, but I think that is better when we establish a dialogue. And I hope that we have other opportunities to establish this dialogue. And vou agradecer em português agora. Gostaria de agradecer muito a este convite.
Thank you so kindly for this invitation.
Ao meu amigo Christopher, my friend. Obrigado pela paciência. Eu não sei se funcionou bem, né, essa condução dessa prática nesse ambiente.
Well, you know, thank you indeed for your patience. I'm not sure exactly, you know, how successful the guided meditation was, in a sense.
E queria dizer que eu acho esse evento do Towards Constellations muito importante.
So I would also like to add that I think this event in the context of Towards Constellations is incredibly important.
E espero que a gente possa continuar essa conexão assim com várias pessoas, né, de vários lugares, que acho que nós estamos vivendo momentos difíceis.
Yeah, so I think it's important that we keep these connections alive and that we continue this process because, as we all know, we're living in difficult times.
Muito obrigado.
Thank you kindly.
Thank you very much, Cassiano, and thank you very much, Christopher. We will finish now the webinar, but I just would like to let my colleague Jorge to explain us what will happen like in the next moments in the online cafe, which is also a place where many people are encountering each other from different places and has a more informal way of meeting. Maybe Jorge, you can just say a few words.
Hello. Yes. First of all, obrigado, muito obrigado, Cassiano. Muito obrigado, Christopher. Christopher?
Christopher. Yes, Christopher. Yes.
Thank you very much. And I heard you are able to keep talking about this. So one of the spaces that we have is the online cafe. The online cafe is this open, this room, this space, open 24 hours. We have some activities there, but also we have a space for people to talk, to keep the conversations, to develop in case we don't have a time, you know? So we will have now a time in the online cafe. I invite people to keep the conversations there. And at 9 p.m. Italian time, we will have Diana Cortez and the Pacific Dance, an artistic group from Tumaco, Colombia, who are gonna show us their work, their dances, and at the same time, they're gonna talk about their pedagogic and artistic processes with youth in Tumaco. And later we will have Luciano Mendes de Jesus.
Yes,
claro que... Tem o Luciano às 11 horas. Não. Não é às 11 horas, não? É às 11 horas?
Online café.
Eles têm esse café que sim, é tipo um fórum, basicamente, para poder continuar essas conversas.
Sim.
It is at 23 Italy time, and às 16 horas, 17 horas no Brasil, eu acho. Não. Não.
É outro santo.
Não, Luciano, às 23 horas, horário italiano, 18 horas, horário do Brasil. Luciano Mendes de Jesus is at 23 Italy time, 18 Brazilian time, and he will talk about the artistic creation around the Visungos. So, I just take advantage also to invite you there, and of course,
come to the time of café is.
O café is the online café is open 24 hours.
Yes.
Yes.
So 24
hours. E o Luciano 6 horas da tarde. Okay. Yeah.
So if somebody has questions, if somebody would like to share some of the questions that were raised here, that's a place where we can meet, okay?
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye.